Welcome back to Spice Morning. Well, thank God it's Friday, and I'm begging your indulgence. We are going to go with a little extra time this morning, probably 10-15 minutes, but I assure you it's good and it's exciting information that you need to know. Mr. Bobby Steele, very well known in the entertainment circuit, well, he is here this morning to speak with us about that motorcade that is carded for tomorrow morning to raise funds and awareness of Mr. Killer as he vie for the crown in the Inner Power Soca Monarch in Trinidad. Welcome to Spice.
Good morning. Good morning.
It's so nice to have you. This is the first time I've been honored to have you as a guest.
It's first time I've been in Sugar. Yes.
Your very first time on.
I did programs before, but not the morning program.
Okay.
Yeah, it's fantastic. The first time I've done the morning.
Right. So how you been?
Good. Yes. Glad to be here to talk about this very worthy cause.
Yes. Well, Mr. Killer has been doing extremely well. He's no stranger to entertainment. He's been doing so well and so often. I don't think it's just myself, but people have said, "Boy, why? When is that break gonna come?" And he's done so much good work in the past, and I mean his relationship with Tempo, and one felt, you know, that it was just a matter of time, but I don't think anybody thought that Roly Poly would have done it.
Well, generally, let me start off by saying, I mean, I've been a fan of Killer for many years, right? In my personal view, this is not the tune I thought I would have done it. Right, honest and say that, right? He has had such good music all around, all through his career. But the support doesn't come for the tune. It comes for the person, the individual, and what he's doing for Grenada and flying that flag out there. I mean, that show next week is the equivalent to entertainment for a soca artist, the equivalent of running in the Olympics. This is the show. This is the International Soca Monarch, you know?
What do you think Mr. Killer is doing different in terms of selling himself and being more charismatic and more engaging to the public than perhaps he was originally perceived in the past?
You know what it is? I think the tune, this particular tune, right, allows, it's different. It's not the normal jump and wave. The soca artists the fans have heard jump and wave so many years in a row. Something needed to come that was different, and this is what it is, I think, is putting him out there, because he is actually not right now. He has a tune besides this one that is doing very, very well, that it's called Sin City. If you listen to it, it says it's on a soca rhythm, right? But it's actually a very up-tempo, I would call it a dance tune rather than a soca tune per se. But because soca and dance are so closely related in the beats, the power soca and the dance, it works. And I actually think that is a tune that is going to carry him for the rest of the year, because it's pretty new and it's doing very well in Trinidad, and I believe it's a tune that it will do much better after Carnival.
Yeah.
You know, so I think he's on the right track. I think he's hit the niche now, you know?
Right. The song Roly Poly, just to quote a little line, years gone by, only maga girl getting the blind. You know, sometimes I sit and wonder, you understand?
Yeah.
So he is just glorifying and saying, you know what, there are some big girls out there that are taking care of themselves. They're
exactly.
Well polished.
They're
not doing anything different. They'll be given some love and some appreciation. How do you think that message has gone across?
Well, I mean, you will always have your critics. You will always have your critics, you know? But I think at the end of the day, he has hit the niche. He's hit, he's catered to that market. He's allowed people to understand, and people are appreciating it. They are appreciating it. You see it in all the fan base, how it's growing. I mean, let me put it, as I said on the radio yesterday, I called Trinidad to talk to a band leader in Trinidad, a very well-known and respected band leader, to beg for assistance for Caracol's Carnival, because we don't have costumes. We need to get costumes to the demand of the people that want to play. His answer, as soon as he got the call from me, he said, "Bobby, when are you arriving?" I said, "No, boy, I can't come this year. I'm committed to Caracol." He said, "Bobby, are you crazy?" The first year that somebody is going to walk out of Trinidad with the International Soca Monarch
You
crown,
can't
and
make
you
it.
are not going to be here to see this happen. I wish I could be there, you know, because in all honesty, you know, the African Canadians that would say, "Boy, yes, he has easy favorite, but he can't win." I am one person. I'm saying it here now. We need to stop thinking like that as Grenadians. I am very, very confident that Mr. Killer is going to win that crown next week. I'm very confident. He has everything that is needed to win it. It's the right time in Trinidad. If you look at something, and I gave an example yesterday. Last year in Trinidad and Tobago, the People's Choice Soca Monarch was Super Blue. In the finals, Marshall beat him in my mind easily on the stage. Performance-wise, Marshall beat him. But you could not give Super Blue. Super Blue had to get that title in a sense because of the people. The people wanted Super Blue to have that title. So what happened? A split. You understand? So both of them won it, right? I believe we are seeing a situation right now that the only place for Killer to come there is first. Whether or not somebody could match him, question in there, and that's what it comes down to, the performance on stage, the presentation. And this is why I say, we cannot put our artists on that stage to go up against people that will be spending $300,000 in a presentation and put our artists up there to compete
With 10
without
total
us.
making.
What? We can't. We will be taking away his ability to win. That is what we will be doing. So, and remember, the whole world is watching this event. You know? The whole soca lovers from China come right back down will be watching this event. This is our opportunity as Grenadians to showcase ourselves in terms of supporting our artists. Whether or not you like the tune, whether or not you're supporting the tune, you're supporting Grenada to win this competition. That's what it is, you know?
In terms of the YouTube hits, I understand that there is in excess of 1 million hits,
Look,
and the fan base is not just Caribbean people.
no, it's
It
not.
is not just
And
black
it's
people.
not just soca lovers either.
Exactly.
Yeah.
In fact, I have a niece that is American, and she has been sending that video to all of her Caucasian and friends of different races in the United States. And immediately, people are doing the same thing because it is catchy. It resonates across all genres, races. It is just amazing.
And let me go further. This is the smallest island in the Caribbean in terms of the soca fan base, right? In terms of the big carnivals, if you want to put it across the Caribbean. And here we have the number one watched video in the world on YouTube, right? We have to acknowledge that. We have to acknowledge what it
Is there
is.
financial benefits
Well,
associated with the hits?
I'm understanding that while there is some finance coming in from it, if it was set up better in terms of like how it went on, there was ways and means.
You
So
can
there's
put
things to learn from it.
advertisement on it, and
Yes,
there are
yes,
things you could
yes.
have done. So there are lessons to
Yeah,
learn
there are
from it.
lessons to learn from it.
Right.
But it sets the artist. This has opened doors, so many doors for people. By what Killer has done, many artists who have taken the approach of, let me just sing a tune and put it out there and not understand what a video, a proper video can do for your song and carry it. You're gonna bet your bottom dollar we're gonna see a lot more soca artists coming up with good videos now. You're gonna see it. It's gonna
Yes,
happen.
yes,
You
yes,
know?
yes. So, Bobby, we can talk for a very long time,
Yeah.
but we have limited time. Tomorrow, something is happening, and
Right.
the objective is to raise much needed financial resources so that
Yes.
Mr. Killer could go on stage and perform to the level of what's his name from St. Vincent, the fireman,
Skinny
Skinny
Fabulous.
Fabulous. You
Yes.
know, the big,
Yes.
elaborate
Yeah.
performances that you see from him. And the only way we can do that is if we raise funds, and people are
For sure.
generous, right?
Yes.
So, what is taking place tomorrow?
Okay, first of all, we're calling it the dollar for soca. That's what it is to us. We're just asking everybody, even if you can only give $1, right? $1 can help and go a long way. Whatever you can give, we want. But a $1 will be enough to help us on each individual difference. We leave at 9 a.m. We're going to leave from on the Lagoon Road. We're going to go through Grand Anse, up the East Coast, down the West Coast, right? And basically, our intention is to try and get in front of the stadium before the relay meet is complete or right as it's finishing, right? Because we don't want to stop what's happening in the stadium. We want them to, because that's very important for our sporting fraternity as well. But maybe right afterwards so that they can also have an
Come out
opportunity
and join
to
in, make a contribution and
yes,
speak.
feel the energy.
Yes,
That's what it is.
yes.
You know what this is about? Just imagine. if each of us gave a contribution, when that happens next week, it's like we are also investors.
We are owners.
We are owners of that product that goes on that stage next week. And that's what you can get from this. Mm-hmm. You know, and like I say, I mean, I really do hope that the government and the people around treat this in the same kind of manner that we would have treated our athletes running in the Olympics, for instance, because this is the entertainment side. I would like to see the song to the wrong so that people can enjoy that Soca Monarch next week together, that we can all be as a nation together in supporting it. This is my cry out to the nation for it.
I know that the minister is very supportive.
Yes.
And she's very excited about this, and she's going to contribute. I know that there are some people from Corporate Grenada who are also responding positively. Anyone that you'd like to say thanks to?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, we want to thank Carib Deco Industries. We want to thank Joey T for the song System, putting a truck out on the road for us. We want to thank who else out there? We have, I can't remember the name of the lady, but there's a lady who donated the banner for the truck,
right?
I want to thank you in particular. We also have Flo, who is putting assistance towards the overall cost of putting the roadshow on. And we want to thank our GPF for giving us out riders and police on the truck, because there is money collecting. You want to make sure that you have proper security. If you're out there and you want to make a donation, you can get in touch with Amanda Smith, right? Or Cheryl Bain, right? They can collect the monies. And there's going to be a team. I understand that Mr. Killer's mom will be also be on the truck tomorrow as well.
And Amanda Smith, I know that she is about to get very involved with the Spice Man Corporation.
Yes.
So she's doing great work. Talpri. We cannot talk about Talpri.
I want to make it clear, because people are saying, Bobby, when I started, they heard Talpri and Mr. Killer, and how come it's only about Mr. Killer tomorrow? I want to make this very clear. Talpri's management contacted us and informed us. They wished us well for the fundraiser. They agreed. They supported in that sense. But because of his sponsor, their obligations, right? They said they would not be able to be involved in it per se.
In the motivator.
But again, I'm glad we support Talpri. He's a very good friend. I wish him the very best. And he is going. He continues to make us proud. Every year is so consistent in what he delivers.
Yes. Notice in his category, though, that is the groovy Soca Monarch. He is going to be going up against
all the big names. Yeah.
In fact, we have people here like Destra, Curran Dubois, Famanapi, Denis Sassiwal, all of the big names he's going to be going up against. And it's the first time he's participating in that particular category, Groovy Soca. And they're trying to dethrone Marshall as well, because he had won in both categories. So I must say, Bobby, congratulations to Talpri.
Yep.
We are proud of him. I remember some years ago going up to Trinidad. Was it Old Woman? One of them songs. But I remember going up and standing in front of the stage as a Grenadian boy, and the excitement was just so pulsating.
I tell people all the time that, you know, I've been in Trinidad Carnival so many years that Talpri is there. And if you're a Grenadian in a way back in the 20,000, 15,000, you feel so proud, because he calls out Grenadians all the time. He wants to see, where are my Grenadian people?
Where they come up.
He has represented us all the time. I remember even in a Soca Monarch, his outfit was Grenadian flag and the Trinidad flag mixing together. And it was one of the first things that really inspired me to say, you know, we need to build this thing. We need to stop looking at carnival as individual carnivals. It's one carnival, different destinations.
Right. And do you know, Bobby, it's interesting that you, because over the years, historically, we've had the challenge of Caribbean integration, Commonwealth, and this and that, since in the days of Gary, T.A. Marshall, they've tried so many different things. Now we have CSME. It may just be our carnivals that will do the trick.
Well, as a matter of fact, they always say music is the most uniting force that we have. Expression, music around the world. You have groups from London. I remember Beatles has united so many people over the world, right? Soca has an opportunity to do that for the Caribbean. It really does. Even a place like Jamaica that years ago said they don't want to have soca, no, nearly.
Yes.
All of a sudden, Jamaica artists are embracing soca,
yeah.
and carnival is growing rapidly in Jamaica, right? So it is a uniting force as a music, and we need to go out there and support it. We need to support our artists who reach this level, and even as they climb up, we need to support it. I'm really hoping that this actual event will be an annual event put on by SMC, that day a roadshow can be done, because they need to find ways outside of government to raise funds for themselves to help to support their art form. So I'm hoping that what we do tomorrow will become an annual event done for the benefit of the artists altogether, put on by the SMC.
Bobby, thank you so much.
All right.
As always, Bobby Steele, very passionate about culture in Grenada, very passionate about supporting our cultural arm in one way or the other. Don't forget, folks, tomorrow it's all about that motorcade starting at 9 a.m. to support Mr. Killers vying for the International Soca Monarch title. Don't forget, we wish Brother Talpri all the best as well. And don't forget, folks, KFC Relay. And